morning, guys. Welcome to Life with Lena. And if you guys are new here, please click that red subscribe button down below. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. It's currently 9:17. We just finished editing my vlog video. Yes, hello. Hello, munchkin. Good morning. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. So I'm also about to edit my main channel. I'm also about to edit my main channel video for today. It's the Easter treats, but I have to still edit it and do a voiceover on it and everything like that. So we have to do that. But I did wake up earlier than I did yesterday, so that's a good thing. That's a big, big plus. Yes, guys. Woohoo! You're doing better already. Oh, yes, boo. Yes. Hello. 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 Ooh, kisses, kisses. Lots and lots of lovely kisses. Okay. I'm like tickling him. You can see his butt. Oh, do you like your tickles? Do you like your tickles? Oh, that's my ear. That's my ear. Okay. Okay. Stop it. Okay. Okay, you're making my ear wet. I don't like my ear wet. That's the one thing I don't like. I love my kisses, but I don't like my ear wet. It's like a wet willy, but like with doggy kisses. Since it's already 11 o'clock and I just finished editing my other video that's supposed to be posted today on my main channel, the Easter treats, which by the way, you guys should go totally check it out. They're so cute. I still have some. My mom has been snacking on them like I left them out, and she's been like snacking on those treats. Anyway, so I'm gonna have this carrot cake creation yogurt. It's like a new flavor they have by Chobani, and I didn't even know that it expires today, but it does. So even more reason that I should try it today. And the reason I'm not having like a full out lunch right now or full out breakfast right now is because I'm about to have lunch. I'll probably just make some chicken nuggets. So I have those chicken nuggets that I purchased like, I don't know, like a week ago, like the freezer ones with my sister. And I figured I would just, you know, eat those up. It's so nice to actually have like some freezer food around in the house. I mean, I could make my own and I would love to make my own. There's just not that much room in the freezer, but I would love to make like freezer crock pot meals and just other freezer food. And I will definitely be doing that in the future. There's no way I'm gonna be cooking dinner every single day and preparing stuff every single day, kind of like Andre does. I prefer to just have everything prepared ahead of time and then just stick it in the freezer and then defrost it or throw it in the slow cooker in the morning or whatever. That's just my little rant about freezerness. And I wish I had like a spare freezer. I will definitely need one of those separate freezers in the future, but I don't have space for that right now. So in the future, I will have lots and lots and lots of freezer food that I prepared ahead of time. Anyway, now rant over. Let me try this carrot cake Chobani yogurt. It does not taste like carrots. It tastes like, I don't know, cinnamon or some kind of other spice, but it does not taste like carrots. Oh, and by the way, those carrot cupcakes I made, everyone loved them so much. I thought they were like the best carrot cupcakes I've ever had, ever. Like, it was so good. And then my boyfriend also shared some at work and some with his roommate and his roommate's girlfriend, and she was obsessed with it as well. She was like, wow, these are like the best carrot cupcakes I've ever had. And I agree. I feel the same way about those. So if you guys are gonna try those carrot cupcakes, you should definitely give that recipe a try. I will have it linked down below again in this video, or you guys could just wait till I post that video because I also filmed it of me making those. So
I got distracted, guys. Well, first let's look at his cute little stretch. Hi, baby. So I got distracted and I don't know how I started looking at this, but I was looking at baby bottle cards, and then I had the brilliant idea to make a baby bottle card kind of like in the Silhouette program so that I could just, you know, oh, he's stretching again. Oh, you're so cute. So I could just have like my machine cut it out, but I wanted to do it like a baby bottle shape. So I just created my whole entire like layout that I would need to do the card, and I think this would work out just fine. So like I made the baby bottle card. This flap like opens, obviously. I made like a separate little square thing in case I wanted to cut out some cardstock, and all these pieces as well for the baby bottle top. So I could cut it out in different cardstock. And then if I wanted to, I could also cut out this doily that says welcome baby. And then just like, you know, stick it on the card or whatever like that. But yeah, so I decided I would just make like a baby bottle card. I think it's super, super cute. Now I'm about to go make some chicken nuggets because I still haven't done that. I uploaded and scheduled my videos to post though, my main channel video. So at least that's all good and dandy. I was also supposed to go shower, but I clearly did not do that. And now it's 12:47 and it's going to be time to walk Kuba soon. So now I can't even shower. So let's just make some chicken nuggets. Well, that was a nice surprise. I literally just finished telling you guys about how I'm making chicken nuggets and then I have to how I have to walk Kuba, and my mom just got home and she took him outside. How nice, how wonderful. That is so awesome. Yummy little chicken nuggets. Also guys, after I said goodnight to you last night, I stayed up so much longer. I went to bed at 2:30 in the morning, so I'm very, very surprised that I even got up at 8:30 this morning. And I don't even like feel tired or anything, which is nice, but I was just looking at Pinterest like all night. Oh my gosh, we're doing so much like Pinterest research on everything. Like I love Pinterest. I could spend hours and hours upon hours on Pinterest all day, every day. Like if I could, I would spend so much time on Pinterest. And I just like pinning a whole bunch of like recipes and things that I want to try. My chicken nuggets should be ready at this point. It's been 15 minutes that they've been in here, so I think they're good to go. Is it me or does it look like they grew bigger? I don't know. We're gonna have a berry white tea today. Kuba was gonna steal my chicken nuggets. He tried it, he loved it. So I made two for my mom that she was gonna have, but she actually just heated up dinner for herself. So I cut those two up for Mr. Kuba, and he's sitting there waiting. They're just really hot, so I kind of wait for them to cool down a little bit before I give it to him. Waiting, he's waiting. All right, mister, here you go. What? You don't want it now? You're kidding me, right? Did you change your mind? Oh, okay, there you go. Now you're gonna eat. Okay, good. Well, he ended up mopping that up. And my tea's also ready. The water is boiling right now. Berry white tea. I put this as a habit for April because I realized I totally forgot about drinking tea after a while. So if I have like a habit tracker, maybe I'll do better. Oh my gosh, guys. Somehow my mug cracked. And I'm like, how is there liquid everywhere? My mug cracked. This has never happened to me ever before. This is weird. That's so sad, guys. My mug cracked. That means I need to buy a new one. No, I'm just kidding, but I really liked that mug. Yep, there's my mug crack. I really don't know how that happened. Like, it doesn't move around or anything, but it definitely cracked, and it cracked all the way through the mug as well. Goodbye, mug. I'll miss you. This will be round number two. I'm in like cooking baking mode, so I'm gonna make some breakfast for tomorrow. It has to like be, you know, has to like sit in the refrigerator for a while because I'm gonna make something with chia seeds, and those have to, you know, like form that gel like thing around the chia seed. I have my recipe here for cinnamon roll muffins. We might still make those, but first I want to make my sweet potato kind of breakfast thing for tomorrow. So I have sweet potatoes that I purchased for, what did I purchase? Oh, for when I was making that curry for Andre. So I bought 3 sweet potatoes because I was thinking, you know, I'm gonna use it all. I ended, because I needed like 3 cups of sweet potato. I ended up only using 1 because the sweet potato was gigantic. So now I have like 2 extra sweet potatoes left over and I don't want them to go to waste. I found this recipe kind of similar to what I ate the other day that my sister made, which was actually really tasty. I'm probably gonna modify it a little bit. Because I'll add in like some granola or something when I'm eating it. But this is like a maple syrup, coconut oil. It's called maple spiced sweet potato pots. We are going to make this and we'll have it for like the next 4 days or so. And we're going to have a nice, nice, nice breakfast tomorrow. You know what's exciting, guys? Today I get to test out my food processor. So this recipe that I'm making requires a food processor. I get to finally test it out. I mean, I only bought it this past weekend. I bought like a cheapo one. I didn't feel like spending money on one because I don't know how much I would be using it. Though there has been times where I was just like, you know what? I wish I had a food processor. Well, I bought this cheaper one. It cost me like $15 with tax and everything. So I hope it is good. But I'm excited that I actually get to use it today.
Yes, girl.
I don't know why, but I love, 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 love kitchen appliances. But I wish that they could make like a lot of appliances that would be like a 10-in-1, for example. Like, I wish they would do that, but they don't. So one problem I could already see is that this is very small. It's only about 1.5 cups that it fits. I could definitely see myself needing like a 4 or 5 cup in the future when I'm making stuff, but this will do for now. We're gonna just see if I even use a food processor, and I could always just like process a little bit and then take it out, put it in a bowl, and then process some more and then mix it all together at the end. It's a little bit more work for me, but if I use it, well, then in the future we can invest in one.
Well, this is disappointing.
It says, do not process raw meat.
Now I don't know how I'm gonna make chicken nuggets. I wanted to make like these freezer chicken nuggets once I'm done with these. Which you basically use chicken and you grind it up or whatever. Like, you put in the food processor and it grinds it up, and then you make your chicken nuggets or whatever. And how am I supposed to make that now if this says do not process raw meat? Now I'm wondering, is there any food processor that allows you to process raw meat, or are generally most of them not to process raw meat, even though people do it anyway?
Mister, what do you want? What do you want for my life? I love you, though. I love you.
I feel like maybe he wants a little treat. I don't know. Is that what you want?
Mister, even though you already had 2 treats today, I'll be nice and I'll give you one more. Yes, I know that's what you want. Now I know. Yes. I'm begging for bacon strips. We can't see you. We can't see you. Oh, hold on, mister. Hold on. This is his please. You're so cute. There you go.
While this is baking, I wanted to make like these treat bag kind of things. I have like a file on my computer to use with my Silhouette machine that could cut out like a treat bag, and this way I don't have to make any like by hand out of paper plates like I did last time. So if I do make the cupcakes today, I will at least have treat bags.
Here's the file for the treat box, and then it also comes with this little tag that you could attach when you put the ribbon on if I wanted to, but I'm not gonna do that, so I just put it off to the side.
I'm thinking I need some kind of like cardstock paper, but I want something that's like a heavier material, not so like scrapbooking paper, like more like a cardstock. I just need to figure out which ones to use.
So I'm gonna use this one because, well, it's not my favorite pattern, and I could totally use it for some treat bags that I'm gonna give away.
And you know, at this point I might as well also just make one of these little tag things as well.
All right, Mr. Machine, make me proud.
Are you guys ready?
Are you ready? Ready, Eddie?
Okay, it's going in. It's going in any day now.
Hello.
Okay. Well, that was a fail.
I think it might be a good idea to turn my machine on and off, and maybe now it'll sync properly so I could... Yes, now it says it's ready.
Woo! You guys hear it? It's going, it's going, it's going!
Aha! Oh my gosh. I have a beautiful treat box. I am so proud of myself right now.
I didn't make this file though. Like, I got it for free from a website, and they had cut lines on it already. So nice. Definitely a lot easier than that paper plate method, even though that works too, if I, you know, if I didn't have time for this or whatever, but I'm doing nothing right now.
Yes, it's adorable, I know. And then I could just put a ribbon through here. It has the nice little holes in it. I'm gonna make one more with this pattern also because I don't love this one. So we're gonna have a green one. We're gonna have a pink one. I went a little overboard, guys. I ended up making 4. Then they all kind of just go into each other like this, so I could just store them like this. I also left the leftover pieces from the paper, so I'm thinking I can make like some flags out of this to include in like future cards that I make, or maybe even some doilies or something like that. I definitely could make a doily out of this one. Maybe even this one. I don't want to go too crazy with the doilies because I don't like it when they're too patterned.
My sweet potato just beeped that it's ready, so I could continue making this. All right, I think it's all good, guys. It's supposed to be, what is it supposed to be like? Until potatoes are fork tender and just beginning to caramelize. I don't know what that caramelized thing means. Thank you.
guys, I think I changed my mind. I think I need to return this food processor and get an actual good one.
I feel like this one barely does anything. It doesn't even have settings for like pulse or whatever, which I think other ones do. There's no even like speed settings on here, and it's just, I don't even know what this is right now. I feel like my blender would work better than this. Is this smooth to you guys? Because I don't know. It looks kind of chunky. I also found like some pieces in here earlier, like big pieces still. I don't know. I feel like I need to just return this and get my $15 back and then invest that $15 into an actual legit good food processor. I don't know. And maybe like a bigger one. Because at the rate I'm going here right now, I feel like I could have just put everything into my blender and blended it all so much faster until smooth than this food processor thing. So here I was trying to make two bowls instead of four like the recipe says, and I end up somehow with six bowls here. I still have to put in the chia seeds, and then I have to put in like my granola that I have, like granola. It doesn't say to put granola as a topping. It says some coconut flakes if you want, but my granola actually has coconut flakes. It has dates, it has oats. So I'm just gonna be really filled in the morning.
I'm looking forward to having this for the next 6 days. And I'm hoping that maybe one of these days, Andre could also try it. I don't know if he would like it, but I would love for him to at least try it.
Okay guys, so my breakfast is pretty much made. I just have to put in the chia seed pudding later and everything like that. Right now it's just divided into sweet potato things. I was also gonna make the cinnamon bun muffins, but I realized I don't have any chopped pecans or walnuts. So I'll probably pick some up tomorrow, as well as some almond butter. We could probably go to Trader Joe's in the morning. Oh my gosh, guys, today is just one of those days, you know, where nothing goes right because I just cut myself while washing that food processor. The blade was mad sharp. Cut myself. Yeah, so now we're bleeding. We have like a cut on my thumb. It also feels funky, like I'm bending my thumb and it feels so weird. I hope I didn't cut too deep or anything. I'm just gonna go shower right now, take a bath, and just try to relax a little bit. I'm actually thinking that maybe later I'll just go to Trader Joe's instead of having to do it in the morning, but I'm not sure yet. It depends on how long my bath takes, how long it takes for my hair to dry. So I think I am gonna go to Trader Joe's today. I don't know what time they close, but I mean, I figured they would close at like 9 or something. It's currently 6 o'clock. Just gonna put some socks on. We're gonna wear some sneakers, but I also want to show you my super cute outfit. So these pants are the ones that I got from Forever 21. I did not get them tailored yet, but they don't look that bad. I mean, yes, they're a little baggy here, but I don't really care. That's just how pants tend to look on me sometimes, as well as this part here that like I don't know, creases weird ways. That happens to a lot of pants with me, so I don't really care. I'm over it. I also am wearing this crop top shirt, and it's just a long sleeve, so I'm super cute. And we're just gonna let my hair dry, and this is my super cute outfit. I also packed some food to go so I could eat this at Polina's house later.
And now we're gonna go be on our way. Thinking Century 21 probably first, just to make that quick return. And then Michael's and Fairway, and then Trader Joe's. Made it to Century 21. Now I just gotta go return this thingamabobby. I picked up my candy melts. I got black, white, and I also found another paper pack that I don't have yet. It's still $8, so I figured I would get it. It's like a cupcakey one, like a birthday one. And I don't know why, but this section always just gets me, like the candy, not the candy, like the cake section. I want to learn how to make beautiful cakes, guys. Beautiful cakes like this. That would be amazing. I'm probably gonna like try to teach myself. I don't know, we'll see. So I did most of my shopping at Fairway. I didn't have time to walk around Trader Joe's. Like, I'm not familiar with that place. There's an hour before they close. And on top of that, I don't know if they sell like tortillas or if they sell like salsa. Like, I'm not really familiar with their store. So I'm just gonna go there to purchase almond butter, which is all I wanted to get, and coconut milk. I really just need to take one whole entire day and see what Trader Joe's has, because I never know what they have. I've been in and out like a few times, but I never actually like got to look around and see what they have, which I need to do one day. All right guys, I did everything I needed to do, and I also stopped by at Starbucks and got a green tea matcha latte with a pump of vanilla, no ice, even though it's like an ice drink, but I just don't like how much ice they put in, so no ice. And I'm just gonna go to Polina's house to drop off some coconut yogurt that she asked me to pick up, and then I'll see you guys soon. Dropped off Polina's yogurt, and I'm just quickly heating up the food that I brought over. I'm so hungry, guys.
So I'm just heating it up so I can eat it and then I'll be on my way back home.
Guys, all that work at the grocery stores, Fairway and Trader Joe's, and I didn't check to see if I had taco seasoning mix because I assumed that I do, and I do, kind of, but I only have half a pouch and I need a whole pouch for the crock pot meal I want to make tomorrow. Kuba, what do I do about that? Anyway guys, I'm just gonna say goodnight because I feel like I vlogged so much today and I'm just gonna start editing you guys already, even though it's only 9:45. Well, it's, you know, it's pretty much time to go get ready for bed anyway. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe down below if you haven't done so already. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. And I'll see you guys tomorrow in tomorrow's next daily vlog. Bye.